Hey folks, my name is Rojo, and welcome back to our Spellcasters only playthrough of Shining Force. When we last left off, we had just defeated Dark Soul, but we didn't defeat him enough, it seems, because he's about to summon the mother effin' Dark Dragon. Oh yes! Yes, at last! You are awakening. I offer myself to you, Dark Dragon. That sounds sexual. Use my power to help cast off your bonds. Bum-bum-bum! And he teleports for some reason. You're free once more. Let all of Ruin tremble. I die fulfilled. Cringe, fools. Mwah, 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 mwah. Okay, now he's dead for real this time, I think. Look at this ugly motherfucker. We're gonna have to destroy him. Oh, yes. It is all true. We've got Dark Dragon himself. We've also got a couple little pads here where these armed skeletons are going to spawn. We can deal with that by putting one of our own people on there. However, these things, Dark Dragon, fairly high attack and defense. Question mark for HP. I think he's got a 200 or so. But one of these does freeze, one does bolt, and one does Demon Blaze, which we sort of saw at the end of the last episode. Demon Blaze being like a... I think he does like a worse version of what Dark Soul does, actually. But, yeah, as you can see, our party's sort of split up here. What I am going to do is, I'm gonna work a little magic via editing, and there's something that I need to take care of before we get into this battle in earnest. So, I will meet you in about a moment. Okay, we're back, and as you can see, I've made a few changes to the force here. Remember that yogurt ring that we got a long, long time ago, back in probably episode 10 or 15? Yeah, I decided it's time to put it to use. So now we have an army of yogurts all ready to go here, and we are gonna bust up this dragon something fierce. So, as I was saying, we've got some skeletons here. I did actually get a couple levels because they started to chase us down. I had to kill a few. But that's no big deal. We got like a level on Max, a level on Arthur, so you can get to level 21 if anyone's interested in that. And then also, Lo leveled up from a heal, and he actually got heal 4, so that's interesting. Now then, let's begin this fucking battle, shall we? I'm gonna sort of slowly move people up here. It's gonna be a bitch to figure out who's who, but that's okay. Okay, maybe we'll put Gong like over here. I'm gonna do like one head at a time, I think. We'll see how these skeletons react. I may have to put someone over on that other platform a little sooner than I like, but we'll give it a try here. Yeah, he seems content to stay put. So we're gonna come over and sneak over here, ever so slowly. This is the actual yogurt, the progenitor, the progenitor race. I don't want to get too close to this dragon head, that's for sure. Okay, we got Tau. I'm gonna leave her over here. We actually may not be able to get to this skeleton in a timely fashion. We'll see. Domingo, we'll send him over this way. Flying yogurts are the best yogurts, of course. Put Max over here, so hopefully he'll tank the hit. We'll see what happens here. Hanzo gets to go, though. We'll see what he can do against this guy. And yeah, it does change your battle appearance, so we're going to be seeing a lot of yogurts. But my thought is, yeah, we'll take over this... or rather, take out this head over on the right here first. And then we shall sort of move over to the left head, and this is for symmetry's sake. And then I'll see about taking out the head in the middle. That's how I like to do it anyway. Henri's gonna get some XP here, one damage. Conserving those MP, they're gonna be important. We need to blow up these dragon heads pretty much ASAP, so not a lot of time to dick around. Can't quite make it to that platform with her. We'll get someone up there, though. And we're going to have our AoE healing pretty much at the ready, because we're going to get lit up as soon as we get over there in range, I'm pretty confident. We'll probably have Arthur manage that skeleton over there, although I would like him to be attacking the actual dragon heads as well. Bit of a tricky situation. Maybe we have Max go over there? Let's see, where is Max at? This could take a while. Low, of course that's Domingo, we knew that. Yogurt, this is Max. Okay, we can have Max go over, maybe take care of that guy. I'd like him to be attacking as well. But Arthur does hit a little bit harder. So we'll send him over. And Max should be able to one-shot this skeleton here, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, okay. So that's good. We can have him manage skeletons on this side if need be. And everybody else can go over this away. Hanzo gets to go again. I think he's going to be safe right here. We'll have to decide who we want to put on the platform there as well. Oh, double attack. Didn't quite get the kill though. Level 16 though. A couple extra HP. You know, it's not good, but it's not awful either. And again, I think we're going to be safe right here. Maybe Gong can get this guy. I'm not sure. Yeah, okay, nice. All right. So we're creeping up to this head over here. We just need to get somebody in that position and sort of spread people out a little bit, because we don't want to get blown up any more than we have to. I don't know which head this is. I think it's the freeze head, but I could be absolutely completely mistaken about that. So I'm going to put Chris over here and move Tarasu up. I'm going to keep him out of range. He's important to us for sure. And Yogurt can hang out over here. So there's another skeleton and another skeleton there. You can, I mean, I guess, like, farm XP here if you really, really want to. I don't know if they end up stop giving XP eventually or not, but here we go. Take out this guy. Does that tile have, like, some land effect or something? We didn't do very much damage to that skeleton. Very curious. So when we move up here, like, we can't stand here because that's too close to that other skeleton, or that other dragon head. Even here, I think they all have a range of 3 with whatever magic they have. So we need to be very careful with how we move here. Okay, does this have land effect? No, I mean, not any more than any other position. But, I think, why don't we get started wailing on this guy a little bit? I think we're going to be safe here from that other one. We'll see. Any damage is good damage at this point. And like I said, I think that these dragon heads have over 200 hit points. So it's going to take, you know, a little bit of effort on our part to actually take these guys out. Now I want to put somebody over here. Who's standing here? Is this Gong, was it? Yes, it is Gong. All right. We'll put Henri here, because she can reach with a freeze 4. See what kind of damage we get going on here. 41, that's pretty good. Can't complain about it. And Domingo, we're actually going to have Domingo. Since his freeze 3 isn't going to do much for us, I don't think, against these guys, we're actually maybe going to have him cast some boosts instead. Against, or on who, though? There's nobody. I guess there's Max, but Arthur's way up there. Boost has a bit of a range, but it's, I don't think it has that much of a range. I think we'll just kind of have him chill out over here for the moment, and we'll get a boost in next time if we can here. Aleph, I mean, her magic isn't going to do much for us here, unfortunately, because she doesn't have Bolt 4, but I mean, I guess we can still hit this guy with a Bolt 3. You know, she's not going to last very long here for us, but we can use her maybe to cover up a platform or something like that. She can stay on this platform, actually, after this dragon head dies. That'll be something good that she can do for us. Okay, Gong may as well come over and do some damage, I suppose. Actually, I mean, it's really not going to do us much good. Instead, I have a better idea. We're going to use his power ring to get a boost on Arthur. Oh, yeah. 15 offense, and our ring didn't even crack, so we'll be able to use it once or twice more here, which is good. I'm going to leave Chris kind of out of the way here. She doesn't really need to be too close to anybody. She has excellent movement range anyway, so important to keep in mind. We'll put Tarasu here, and Yogurt, you can stay here. Yogurt has one of our Shower of Cures, which is going to be very important for us. We can afford to put Tao here, I suppose. Or, well, who's standing? It was Henri who was standing on there. Either way, I think we're going to get blown up here, so we may as well, let's put her here, I suppose. We'll do a Blaze 4. We can actually have her do boosts as well, but I think a Blaze 4 will be fine here. More, probably more efficient mana-wise, since boost doesn't last that long. I could be wrong. Then I'm going to have Arthur stand here. We'll see what happens when this dragon head gets to go. Hey, there we go. We're getting through this guy. 22. One defense. Yeah, his last level wasn't very good either. I think he just got like one attack or something. So what is this guy doing to us? He's doing Blaze. Okay. So maybe one of them doesn't have freeze. Blaze magic is not really all that big of a deal. And yeah, I wanted to put Max here because he is, let's see, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, he's out of range of that other one just in case it has a range of 3. We should be able to get some good damage going on here. Another 31. Oh, a double attack even. Excellent. This is going very smoothly so far. Okay. And then we can have Hanzo could finish this guy off, actually. Yeah, that's fine, but let's do it from here. And my thought is then we can move Henri off of that platform and hopefully get Aleph on there ASAP. Or even we could put Yogurt on that one if we wanted to. Start moving people over this way again. Yes, I think we're going to be okay there. I'm going to get some of our fighters in the proper position, though. Move Henri down. And, curious. Yeah, I think this will be fine if we can get Yogurt up there. I think we'll be able to do it. He's got a movement of 7. He's pretty fast. Okay. That skeleton's not moving yet. That's good. Actually helps out a lot. Here we go. There's Yogurt. Put Yogurt right here. And then we can move Arthur down as well. And we need to get a heal out on Hanzo for sure. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3. I think is how that goes. So we're certainly going to be safe here at least. I don't think anybody has more than 3 range for spells, so okay, we'll move Max down here, I think. And there's Hanzo. We'll get him healed up by somebody here. Oh shit, we put him right in the middle of everybody, didn't we? Yeah, alright, that's okay. We'll put Gong over here. And we'll put Aleph over here. And we can have Lo come over here. He doesn't have any AoE heals anyway, so he can take care of this. I think he might have a Shower of Cure as well, if I recall. I think I gave him one. So that could come in handy for us. To be honest, I didn't think we'd be killing these heads quite as quickly as we are. Could be wrong about the amount of HP they have, absolutely. Yeah, this guy's gonna come down now. I think I put Chris maybe a little bit too close. Could be the case. Alright, Tarasu goes here. Yogurt stays there. You can see that head is all busted up real good. Arthur can actually reach this guy, so we're gonna just take him out preemptively here. Don't want to mess around with skeletons getting to wail on our guys too much. 116 damage, deadly attack. What a monster. What a effing monster. The boost spell ends. Aw, sadness. That's okay. That's okay. It did its job. Alright, we got Max. We're gonna bring him over. And we gotta figure out, I guess we'll put Aleph on that other one for sure. And then, let's see, Domingo, yeah, you're fine to go over here. And Gong can go up here, like so. Okay, we're getting there. We're almost back over there. And, yeah, what's maybe there? That's okay. And Aleph, there's our girl. We gotta make sure that she gets in the right spot. By the way, I don't think I ever... I said videos ago when we first got her that I had mentioned what her race is. She is a Wulpus, or whatever. I think that's the Latin word for fox, basically. She's a foxling. But that's the official race. Tarasu is a hobbit like Lo is. And Hanzo, I believe, is just a human. Well, I say just, but he's a fucking ninja. So, that's something. Okay, we got Max here. Oh, we could actually come right up here with Max. If we want to get real crazy here. Start wailing on this guy. Gotta be careful. I think one of these does have Bolt 4, so that could hurt. A lot. Yep. Oh, we're just gonna get attacked, I think. Yep. For one damage. Not terribly impressive. Okay, we'll start getting other people up here. We can actually have Domingo stand here and do a boost on Max, I guess. That's something. Very nice. And Gong, we'll have Gong stand on this for now, just to make sure we don't get another one of those guys. Let me just make sure we put Aleph up there later on. And in fact, here we go, we'll have an opportunity to do a Bolt 3 on this guy here. And that'll be most of her magic pretty much expended here. She's got enough for like one more freeze. We really desperately need one. Okay, we'll put Henri. Where will we put Henri? Let's see, 1, 2, 3. So she could get hit from there. But she can stand here and actually still hit this guy. So that is what we will do. Freeze forward to the face. Ba-bam, and a deadly attack. 69 damage. Holy crap. Alright, Chris. What does Chris even have here? Or slow, quick, and heal. I think we'll just kind of chill out for a minute. And same with you. And I was correct about our range. That's good. Bring Arthur up over here and hit this guy in the back of the head. And yeah, we can already see the HP bar. Level 23. And Tao can actually reach over here. Oh, but that puts us in the danger zone, so I don't think we'll do that. We don't want to get our whole party AoE'd here. Domingo has a ton of MP. Wait, did I have Tao cast a boost last time? Is that what happened? That might have been a little bit of a mistake. Well, whatever. This is fine. 17 damage is not much, but it helps. Okay, Hanzo. Yeah, we'll stick Hanzo. We'll tuck him in right over here, I think. And hopefully we'll kill this dragon before he gets to cast any bullshit on us. I mean, Hanzo isn't really killing it damage-wise either, so... But I think Max will probably take this guy out. Pretty sure. Yep, no sweat. Especially with the boost on, anyway. Alright, that's two heads down. We are almost done with this fight already. We'll, put Low over here, I guess, and we can move Gong down as well now. And Henri, we can move her down. Chris, we can keep her over here. There's Aleph. Alright, so we're gonna put Aleph here. And we'll leave Tarasu here. Leave Yogurt there. Alright, I guess we can have Arthur start attacking this guy. 32 damage. We're getting there. Tao can come over, absolutely, and actually, can she even reach a little bit further? No, not quite. We'll move her next time, maybe. We'll do a big blaze on this guy. And who else? Oh, yeah, that's gonna do some damage. The Demon Blaze. The big Demon Blaze. It hurts a lot. A lot. That's why we gotta be careful. Hanzo, you can go here. Start attacking this guy. Ooh, a double attack even. And Max, you can stand over here, that's fine. Slowly but surely. Let's see now, does Lo have a, yeah he does. So this is what Shower Cure does, if you're interested. Basically, it just goes through everybody who's still alive in the party, and I think it, I've read somewhere it does like 40 hit points of healing, but it's more or less, might as well be a full heal. I mean, it does so much. And we'll leave Aleph right there, she's done her job. We can actually sneak Domingo up right behind this guy, which is kind of funny. Yes, we will do a freeze on this guy. We'll see what, if we're getting to his HP bar or not. Not quite yet. Henri, we can get her in here for a freeze 4, that's totally fine. Just like so. I wonder if we can cast boost on Yogurt. Yep, there we go, we're getting down to the HP bar now. Okay, Gong. We'll send Gong over this way, I think. Just to kind of keep him out of the way a little bit, if nothing else. Chris, not much for her to do right now. And Tarasu is not much for him to do either. Yogurt, you will stay there, my friend. And we can have Arthur attack this guy again. 35 damage. We're getting there. What if we were to have Tao do like a Blaze 3 on this guy? We could kill him. I'm curious to see what happens if we do it something like this. 13. He's gonna get to go again, of course. It's gonna hurt a bit. But these guys have enough HP that it doesn't really matter. Even if they took deadly attacks, they would all be fine, I think. What I would like to know, though, is can we finagle this in such a way that we have something awesome happen? I want to see what happens when we cast boost on Yogurt. Not freeze, boost. There we go. We'll cast boost on Yogurt. And supposedly his offense is increased by 15. We'll look at his stats though and see if that is in fact the case. It did work on him, so you can boost Yogurt. Very interesting. Not that it matters, because his attack is still only 16. But it is interesting. Alright, we'll stay with Hanzo. And let's see, how many HP does this guy have? 10? Let's try something. Let's see if we can be cute with this. We'll do a freeze 1 on this guy. Hopefully it doesn't kill him. It does not. That's something. Okay, and then we can have low stay put. We have another Shower of Cure on somebody here. Oh, either way, we can actually just have Chris come up here and do a an aura spell on these two guys at the very least. And that'll help out. Okay. And then Gong can actually come over here and do a heal 3 on Hanzo. He's back to full HP, so that's good. Alright. So we got that, we got that. Tarasu can actually do a an aura on these guys as well, just to sort of get them back into a good spot. Okay, now the question is Dark Dragon healed yet? He has not. Now, Yogurt's only going to do one damage, but this is our chance. This is our chance for Yogurt to be a hero. Can you do it? One! Oh, only one attack. Oh, and the arm skeletons are back. What we want to do is actually move Max away a little bit, if we can. Oh no, Yogurt's going to die! Oh, that's disappointing. That's sad. He only took 13 damage from that Demon Blaze. That's interesting to me. Well, we tried. I guess we finish this off with a big old blaze. And there you have it! Level 15! Dark Dragon has been defeated! At any rate, that's going to be it for me. I certainly appreciate you all coming along on the old quest to save Rune here. Had a lot of fun, had some ups and downs, but overall, I'm glad I did this kind of playthrough. It was really interesting to see how your tactics change a little bit when you're using, you know, characters who are a little bit less strong in melee. You know, you got to be a little bit more careful with them. And, you know, it was cool to get a lot of spells. We didn't quite get them all, but we got a hell of a lot more than I usually do. But yeah, once again, thanks for sticking with the series, and until next time, my name has been Rojo, and thanks for watching. Okay, so I really wanted to end the series having the actual yogurt kill Dark Dragon, because I thought that would be pretty cool. I was a little disappointed that we didn't get it, so I played through the battle again one more time, and here we are. This is it! Yogurt! The hero! Yes! Alright. Well, that's gonna do it for this playthrough. Again, I really appreciate you guys sticking with it, and I'll see you next time.